down here at the bottom right on our two-player map. I should say upper right.
Yeah, right side of that.
Is San Zenith. Already got some fans out here cheering for him. Up here at the upper left, the favorite of this match. But you never know.
OGS InCa.
OGS InCa.
And, you know, I got to say, it's so funny seeing those pictures in front of the match with a thumbs down, that InCa picture. He's such a nice guy.
Yeah, he's a really friendly guy.
It's just funny seeing him with that thumbs down. And I think we're going to be seeing a proxy racks here from OGS InCa, maybe.
Oh, my God. Is he going to do it?
Racks in the main base.
Oh! Whoa! Spots it.
And InCa can't be happy with that.
I think I just made the sound of a cat being killed when I screamed like that. Well, that messes up everything. OGS InCa hoping to do an all-in, but it's spotted before he can actually do that. San Zenith actually checking to see if he's going to do that.
Trying to block what he can. Cannot be happy with that. San Zenith, he's going to be... What? I think a Korean observer. Messing up a little bit there. Anyways, you know, San Zenith is going to be thanking his lucky stars about that little scout pattern he had there with that probe, bringing it up.
Yeah.
Behind.
No kidding.
Now, InCa is pretty much just going to be behind mineral-wise nonstop because he sent this probe out so early. In fact, if we take a quick look at the income tab, you see that constantly... his economy is just slightly behind. But.
Now, this is just so interesting because I don't know if InCa had too much of a game plan other than this. I mean, he's a very talented player, but obviously he was banking on just winning with sheer micro. Now he's got to play this out by ear. And, you know, Scrap Station is a pretty unique map. It's not a map like, you know, that's more generic like Metalopolis where you can just do anything. So... I'm curious to see if Inca's backup plan, his plan B, if you will, is going to be as powerful.
Yeah, you know, he's got to just let it not phase him, I think.
Because
he's such a high-level player. I feel like if he just plays really, really, really well from here, he should do fine against San Zenith. I really do believe he's a higher-level player overall.
Yeah, I agree with you completely. Now, right now, he's going to charge out the Stalker, getting Warp Gate. We'll usually see what the Protoss is doing after... the probe is chased out. You don't want to reveal your tech until then. And you can see the same thing's going to happen. InCa smartly leaves right before the Stalker pops out. Same is true for San Zenith.
Stalker out.
And
time to tech.
Do we see his tech yet? We're still waiting. We're going to have another gateway and a third gateway. Very interesting. He's going to go for a bust.
Oh, a couple more gateways as well for InCa.
Very interesting. I really did not expect that, actually. Mm. I didn't know they were both going to go for the same type of build order here. This is very interesting.
But still, the income for San Zenith is just better. He's got a couple more, look at this, Dragoon.
So we see, the income is just slightly improved for San Zenith. We understand you guys want us to use the clock feature. We don't. There's a new feature for that.
Yep, it just came out in the patch.
Oh, okay. It looks like the probe is taken out. I don't actually know. Did he get vision of that? One second. No, he didn't see either of the two gateways.
Nice move there. San Zenith, in the meantime, is going for a robotics facility.
So he's staying one base pretty heavy.
Also, a robotics facility going up for InCa. So pretty much mirroring each other completely.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting. Because eventually somebody's going to have to expand. Uh-oh. He may have overstepped his boundaries here. Chasing the Stalker out. You can see Inca's on the move. San Zenith retreating. Is he going to get this one Stalker?
Well, they are the same speed, so I'm going to say no.
I do not believe he's going to catch into him.
No.
Unless he zigzags when he runs away like you're supposed to do when you're being chased by a crocodile.
Yep. Crocodiles don't turn quickly, but they can move forward really fast.
That's true.
Also, don't go in the water. They swim faster than
That's true. Good tips here. Oh, wait. Hold that thought. We have something very interesting going on here. A hidden pylon. I'm curious to see what that's going to be. Perhaps he wants to hide his robotics bay so he doesn't know his opponent's getting Colossus with the robotic facility already in here.
And adding hidden tech onto, you know, just doing a good build this game.
Might as well.
Yeah, it'd be a good move by San Zenith. I think he realizes, you know, he's a bit below Inca.
Observers spotting each other. So he's not going to let him in there. We still haven't seen what is going to be used with this, but is this probe actually going to spot this? He can see the pylon.
Oh, I like that. And if I were him, I would not go down and scout it right now. I would just send some stalkers down and just take out whatever's being made.
Yeah, let him make whatever he's going to make and then punish it.
But he isn't making anything down there. Both of them are getting robotic support base, though.
Okay, he's supply blocked, but only temporarily. Gloss is on the way. He's charging it out. Now, I guess he's just not going to use that hidden pylon now. Mm. That strategy's kind of too late.
Yeah. Big choice of him to actually back off that. But a Nexus going up for Inca. Good timing on the Nexus. I feel like he cannot really be busted. He's going to be making, of course, the Colossus, so should be fine.
Now, Inca is going to have his Colossus out a little bit quicker here.
Also, no, Inca has skipped a lot of probes now, only 33 against 38.
Oh, yeah, that's a very good point.
So he's actually saving some money that way. He's going to work on his economy a little bit later.
So as you can see, San Zenith just focusing on making probes, building up gradually. Meanwhile, Inca cutting corners here to try to get ahead in tech and expansion. He's going to be making more probes later on.
Yeah, get a nice, big, strong army, and then just pump out your probes really, really fast.
As we can see here, San Zenith getting that immortal first. That's one of the big questions in PvP is, do I actually want to squeeze out that immortal?
Too immortal or not too immortal, that is the question.
That is the question. Someone give me a Hamlet skull. This is interesting, though. He skips the immortal, gets the Colossus. Nobody, by the way, breaking down the rocks as well, which would allow them easy access to each other.
Well, when you break down those rocks, it becomes stressful for both players, whether you're attacking, defending, whatever, just sitting there.
Yeah, things start to heat up.
And who wants to be stressed?
I don't want to be stressed.
Not me.
No.
Get that.
They've actually done a great job of pushing the observers out of each other's base. Inca's a little bit more aggressive with his observer. He's actually the one trying to pursue intel. Meanwhile, San Zenith is the one who's kind of defending. By the way, San Zenith's expansion completes.
The probe count evening up quite a bit here. And Inca's supply, in fact, going ahead at this point.
Wow. Inca's actually just slightly ahead in supply. Inca definitely knows how to balance out his probe usage.
See Thermal Lance. San Zenith getting that. Getting another robotics as well. So looks like he wants to go for a heavy, heavy Colossus.
Now we see... Again, it's kind of a passive moment in the game. We see more and more Colossus being cranked out here. He did take out the pylon eventually. And that is just another little thing that's in the way for San Zenith. Things not quite working out. At least he did spot that would-be proxy game.
It seems like half this game, by the way, is chasing around that observer.
Yeah, no, it's been a serious
cat and mouse game.
They're actually,
both of them just keep chasing.
That's really high-level PvP in StarCraft 1. We can see those skills have kind of transferred over to StarCraft 2.
Now, something pretty interesting. They're actually diverging a little bit on their unit counts. Inca is actually going for a heavier Zealots. He's got 15. That's over double the 7 of San Zenith. And he's going for a lot of Colossus as well. That's going to save him gas, make him be able to get more Colossus.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, San Zenith going, you know, a little bit more standard. You know, he's got some Zealots, yeah, but he's got a few more Stalkers. Very stylistic.
He's once again managed to sneak his Observer in here. Actually, both of them now getting a lot of intel here. Finally, after so much time spent with them unable to kind of spot what each other are doing, there's too much pressure. They have to both keep making Colossus. They can't afford to get another Observer.
Yeah.
So that's actually huge in PvP.
It does cost 100 gas, and that's also why Immortals are quite dangerous to get. Takes out his rocks. Will he take out the other rocks? He's got a lot of Colossi. 5 against 5 right now.
Gets another probe over here. The spot for this gold base. You want to be careful in mirror matchups. Your opponent doesn't just sneak a base up over there. He's going over the rocks. I don't know if he should do this. I think this concave here is definitely going to favor Inca.
Yeah, he's going to be able to spread out very well against this.
He does get the observer. And he's going to try to move in. Will he do it? The spread is pretty solid, yeah, to be honest.
I don't think anything in the world can attack into that.
Not even Artosis.
No, man. I play Zerg. I can't attack into one Colossus.
San Zenith backs off. Now, this is where this matchup gets weird, is because you're going to expand here next, but then there's this big opening, this hallway into your base. Inca. As you guys can see here, Inca, actually, they're almost even now in supply. So this
very
is getting
close on that.
This is getting kind of weird.
Who's going to take the third base?
That's the big question. Actually, you know what? If he gets in this position, he's going to have Inca stuck. This is going to be the small area Inca can't get out of.
He could run through to counter, but then that's the counter distance is actually shorter for San Zenith.
That's true as well.
Things get messy very quickly when you have this many Colossus in play.
You also got to be careful to make sure your Colossus in the back are actually doing damage and they're not just bumping into the Colossus in the front.
Oh, of course. But they have such range. Siege Colossus, really.
Oh, spots it just in time. The gold expansion.
Has to decide, do I walk down there? Do I walk across? What do I do here?
I don't know if Inca's handling this very well. He's been, just been kind of sitting back. See, he might try to make a pylon over here. Oh, yes, he does.
Good move. I like that.
Yeah, maybe make like 4 Zelts, just go for the Nexus, try to take it out that way. Inca's sort of boxed in right now. San Zenith has intel everywhere. God, it's so many Colossuses.
Yeah, yeah. And San Zenith is actually getting plus attack upgrades, which I like quite a bit because it counts for the Colossus, adds a lot of damage on. And that's kind of one way to help you get the edge in these battles.
Okay, he's moving out. The spread is pretty even here.
Send Colossus.
Guardian Shields. He's going to engage. Inca does not have his Guardian Shield yet. He does, but the Guardian Shield is in the front force field here. It looks like San Zenith is doing a little bit better here, but it's really hard to say. Actually, he's not controlling his Colossus in the back, right?
That's right. Look at this. War of the Worlds. Just so many Colossi. Inca has a better spread.
Inca actually has much better spread. Damn, that was really good. That might be game.
That's it, man. Colossus, you just have to have the better spread, which Inca had, and there's really no recovery from this. Look how many he has.
Yeah, he has too many now. Inca controlled the Colossus too well. Even though the Guardian Shields are up a little bit faster for San Zenith. And now he moves in here. And here we see the Stalker, which is basically just a midget Colossus.
He wants to be a Colossus when he grows up. But actually, he already grew up and died. That's why he's a Stalker.
He's setting his probes with it. There it is. GG.
Wow.
Wow.